Welcome to my CMS Assessment 2.0. The purpose of this assessment is to see what students have taken away from this week's vocabulary lesson. It goes with the story that we do every 2 weeks, so it's just checking if they understand, and it's a quick check for me to see if I need to go back and reteach or not. The context is fourth grade language arts vocab. It goes with our story that takes place in the Southwest, so the words relate to that. It also aligns with a Common Core English Language Arts Standard. Acquire and use accurately grade appropriate general and domain specific words and phrases. In this video, I'm going to go a little bit more into detail about the rubric. Real life. This assessment is real life applicable because some of the questions show that they are applying it to real life. So this first one, in a complete sentence, give an example of why a baby would be bawling. You can see in their responses that because he's hungry, tired, wants to drink water, lost their teddy bear, they're applying it to real life. This assessment also has self-assessment at the bottom. They got to rate themselves on a scale of 1 to 5 and be able to explain them to someone would be 5. So feeling very confident about that. Understanding. This assessment shows understanding much more than just a multiple choice quiz because they're having to explain something in words, and that's a higher order thinking skill. This assessment shows valid evidence. The responses, if they are valid, will make sense. So for the baby bawling example, the baby was bawling because they got scratched, because someone stole his puppy, they're hungry or upset. Those are all valid evidence because they make sense in the context of the question. If I saw something that was completely unrelated, it would not be valid evidence. This assessment also informs future instruction. If the evidence is not valid, like making a connection to valid evidence, a reteach would be necessary if I saw things that didn't make sense or a lot of students didn't understand a certain word. So I think it's great that I have can see all the responses on the screen together, and especially a dude that was a weird concept for them. So it was great that they were able to explain what it is for the most part. The reason why I used a Google form is because we use Google Classroom. It's very fourth grade friendly. It syncs to my drive. It's easy to create and assign in Google Classroom, and I really like using it. Thank you.